Thank you so much for joining us here at KEXP, where the music matters. We are listener-powered radio. We want to thank all of our listeners for keeping it that way. You can learn more about us at kexp.org. Make a gift anytime to help support discovery of great live music and so much more. And we've got a great live band here in the studios with you today. I'm Cheryl Waters. I'm so happy to have Altin Goon back for a repeat performance. We're so, so fortunate that you always make time to stop by. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having us.
A beautiful new album called Ashk. I can't wait to talk about it, but even more, I can't wait to hear you play these songs live.
Thank you.
başımdan bulanır canım oy. İner ovayı dolanır canım oy. Sende çok haller bulunur canım oy. Dağlar duman olur, çayın çimen olur. Ben yar görmezsem halim yaman olur halim yaman olur vay vay. Ben yar görmezsem halim yaman olur halim yaman olur.
We're live in the KEXP studios with Altin Goon playing songs from their new album, Ashk. Am I saying that right?
That's perfect, yeah.
Leylim Ley, Leylim Ley, Leylim Ley.
You're listening to Altin Goon live on KEXP.
Bir elinde bağlama, kömür gözlüm ağlama. Ben buralı değilim, bana gönül bağlama. Babanı kandır, anam dünden razı. Bir elinde cura, çal vura vura. Küçük hanım geliyor, bel kıra kıra.
That is so wonderful. We're live here in the KEXP studios with Altin Goon. That sounded amazing. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It was almost 6 years, almost to the day, since we did our first session together in Rennes, France at the Transmusic Hall Festival. And I remember the video team and Morgan coming back with this exciting news about this band that they discovered there. And I can't believe that it feels like at the same time that was like a million years ago and just yesterday. And it's just been so fun to watch the band over that time and the success that you've achieved. Are you able to think back to that time and think about what your aspirations were for a band at that point?
We had none.
I guess, I mean,
We didn't expect much when we started.
No, we didn't expect much. No.
Yeah. And I think when we recorded the KEXP session, we didn't even have an album. Did we have the singles out yet? I don't even think so.
I think we had a single out. Maybe, yeah, Gocha Dunya. Yeah.
We knew you had at least one song because that's how we knew that we wanted to have you. But yeah, you didn't have, I think that was 2017. Mm-hmm. So none of the albums were out yet.
No.
Goodness gracious. Well, I mean, you've traveled so far. And I know at the beginning you talked about wondering what kind of an audience that you would have since you have sort of a niche sound and thought that it would be kind of a small audience. And one of the great things about your sound and your audience is you can be on so many bills. So you can be turning yourself on to new audiences all the time. And have you really thought about why it is that a band that sings in a language that not everyone understands, which I guess is true of every language, but can resonate with so many people? I know that when I go to your live show, I find myself singing along and I don't even know. I just grasp the words that I can remember and just shout them out. But clearly your music is speaking to a large number of people. Do you just go with the flow or do you think about why that is? Or have people told you?
I mean, I don't know why that is, but like recently we were in Mexico. It was our first time playing there and everybody was singing along phonetically. Like, obviously, they don't speak Turkish, so it's just amazing. I mean, yeah, I don't know. Why do you think that is?
That's hard to say. I don't know. We just do what we love to do, and we're really glad that people like it. But we don't overthink it too much. Like, it's just like, yeah.
Well, like a lot of people, in 2020, you had some big plans that you didn't get to follow through, but you ended up putting out two albums during a time when you weren't able to tour, and you worked in a different way during that time, which kind of gave you a new sound. And I know that you've kind of gone back to your live sound on Aşk, but is there anything that you learned in putting together Yol and Alem that you've sort of taken forward, a different way of working together or recording music that kind of sticks with the band and you learn new things about yourself in making music?
Yeah, I think so. But yeah, like you said, for the new album, we really went back to our roots. But I think we learned a lot during pandemic also, like about arranging songs. And maybe it also inspired us to maybe start thinking about creating some originals, I think.
We're just thinking
out of the box, and just there's so many opportunities when you start working from home and with electronics. And maybe the next album is going to be more a combination of those two approaches. I'm not sure.
Well, you do use traditional Turkish songs, and I'm curious what that looks like. Would a person who grew up listening to those songs recognize them? How much do you transform them? Do you change the lyrics as well as the music and the rhythms, the titles of the songs? Are they things that people would recognize that grew up listening to those songs?
Absolutely. Everybody would know. We never change lyrics necessarily. But for instance, the last track we played, Doktor Civanım, It's an Istanbul traditional song, and we absolutely changed the music and the approach and everything. We just used the words and some little vocal melodies, I guess. So it depends. Like usually we stick to the originals, but I guess play it our way. And titles. These songs have also many different titles because they're folk songs. Somebody calls it this, somebody calls it that. So we try to pick what's most common, I guess.
I imagine there's a nearly unlimited amount of songs that you could choose from. You say you might start mixing in some originals, but will you never run out of source material? And where do you find all these? Do you know them from growing up, or are you crate digging for these?
Yeah, I mean, we, me and Erdinç know a lot. Jasper knows a lot. And Jasper sometimes, you know, comes up with ideas and we're like, oh, maybe it works, maybe it doesn't. And I don't know. We're really into sort of creating some original songs lately. And we made a cool couple of tracks. So next album, who knows? It's probably going to be a mix.
Yeah, you've been living with these songs for a while. Yeah. And I know that you love to play live. That's sort of the... the nuts and bolts of this band getting out and seeing you live is just something special to behold. I never get tired of it. So I appreciate all the times that you visit us here at KEXP.
Thank you so much for having us.
We're so happy to have Altin Goon live in studio today. The new album, Ashk, absolutely beautiful. And thank you to them always for stopping by and making time for KEXP. And you can discover great music on our YouTube channel. Subscribe. You'll get notification every time we launch a new video. Thank you once again.
Thank you.
Thanks.
It's Altin Goon live on KEXP Seattle.
Discover new music at listenerpoweredkexp.org.